Okay, howdy folks. So what we're going to do here is attempt to make a pot of coffee on an inverter while boondocking. Let me make sure I turn the inverter off. And let's see, let's turn the water heater off, GFIs leave on, turn the reefer off, microwave. AC. Let's just turn everything off anyway. Okay, and this coffee pot is, let's see if I could see it here. It says 900 watts right there. 900 watts. It doesn't use 900 watts. We're gonna find that out. My inverter button is over here. Sorry, it's dark. It's a little dark. We're gonna turn it on. Okay, the inverter is on. And let's go back here. So let me grind some coffee, get this all set up with water and plugged in. This doesn't read the right voltage. Because I guess you need an RMS. It says 135 volts. I don't think that's accurate. I will unplug that. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, so I got my coffee. Water's in there. That shuts like this. I am not plugged in. The inverter's plugged in. It shows full batteries. Just go out and see what we got here. I'll show you what's going on. So, I'm not plugged in. There's my 280 watt solar panel. This is, I just plug it in like this when the camper is at home. And this is what we would be doing when we're boondocking. So, that water comes in over there and comes into my trolling motor input that I made. Let's open this up here. So it's raining out, completely overcast, and what I'm getting on my charge controller is a half an amp. I'm at 12.9 volts and this says 13.3 volts. I don't know which one's accurate. I don't have a monitor inside, so I just rely on this and the inside button to check the battery. So you see I'm 13.2 volts here, drawing 0 watts. There's nothing on but lighting inside. Okay, so we'll leave that on voltage. This one 12.9, and I'm plugged in here, and I'm plugged into my outlet that I made, Power Trailer 30 amp, and let's go make some coffee and we'll come back out. See what we're drawing. So will my batteries be at 13 volts when we wake up? Probably not. Let's give it a shot here. So while I have his lights on, and we're gonna make like a pizza after this test. Okay, here we go. Turn it on. Boom. Coffee pot's on. Just see if that starts brewing. Let's do a voltage test here. Oh crap. Let's see what we're at here. 147 volts. That's crazy. That is not accurate. I know that. Okay.
coffee's a brewing. Batteries are down 2/3. It's really full. Let's see what it's like here. Okay. Shows 12 volts there. Shows 12 volts here. So now they're kind of accurate. It went into bulk charging mode. I'm still not even getting an amp on a cloudy day. And we are drawing 942 volts from the coffee maker. Okay, so it's drawing more watts. Watts. It's drawing more watts than the coffee maker's rated for. I have a 2-gauge wire here. 2-gauge and 2 12-volt batteries. 2-gauge coming through. Okay, let's wait till that's done and see what our
battery voltage is
when this is done brewing. 12 volts. Okay. This turns off at 10.5, so 936. Okay. And why this is brewing, if anybody could understand how GFIs work, I have a green light and a red light there. I don't know why. The GFI does not trip if I reset it. Will not work on this modified sine wave inverter. I don't know why. Okay, that's just an afterthought. Batteries are still at 2/3. Okay. Now if I had full sun, of course, I'd be dumping probably 15 amps into the mix. Okay, we'll be back. I'd also like to note for this test, I have the starting battery and I have a camper battery. I was having problems because rainwater was getting in here and overfilling this battery. So I put this lid on here to protect it with Velcro under there so no water gets in the battery. You can see this is a bad GM design and you need sealed batteries. Not on that side. So what I do, the truck would be the other direction. I turn it around and I would have it plugged in. I have the umbilical cord plugged in to the truck, and what this does is it gives me this 70 amp hour battery. We'll add onto these two 75 amp hour batteries, giving me 220 amp hours. And there's a regulator back there where it will not discharge that battery, so I can leave it plugged in overnight. And I have remote start on here. I could remote start it while in there and have the alternator charge everything up. But for this test, I'm not doing that, because not everybody has that. All right, so completely overcast day. It's still brewing. We're drawing 1 amp in, still at 12 volts. We're at 948 watts. The coffee is still brewing. I'll post back as soon as the coffee's done and we'll see what the voltage is. Okay, coffee's still brewing. You see we're at 59.9 hertz. Voltage I wouldn't trust because it's not an RMS reader, I believe. Might be accurate, I don't know. 146 volts. I would think that's wrong, but with a draw on it, it goes up that high. Otherwise, it's 130 something volts, so who knows? Show correct polarity. Coffee is nearing the end of the brew cycle. We're still at 2/3. These two 12-volt batteries. Okay, I'll be back. the fan finally came on the inverter. It's not that warm. Coffee's still brewing. 900. This 1100 watt inverter, 954. I don't run anything else when I'm making coffee. We are doing pretty good on an overcast day. I'm in 29 amps. The voltage went up because now we're drawing coffee maker completed its cycle. So we're drawing no wattage. Now I guess the burner is going to use some type of wattage. We'll see. I'll get a picture when that comes on. Just came on. 900. And so I guess the burner uses the same amount of wattage, but it will maybe cycle on and off more. We'll see. I'll watch that for a few minutes. 12.4 volts. Let's see what this is. 12.8 volts. So we're still pretty charged. As I says, they're not accurate. I think this one is more accurate than this. 12.5 volts. Because this I'm on big weld welding cable, 2 gauge, and I think the volts is more accurate here. 12.9 volts. Coffee maker completed its cycle. Okay, so apparently the hot plate just came on. Apparently it uses the same wattage as brewing the coffee. Okay, so that brings it down. It doesn't stay on long. It just clicked on and off. So it goes up to 900 watts, comes down, and it cycles through this behavior. I'm at 12.8 volts, 12.5 here, 1.5 amps going in. All right, so let's turn that coffee pot off. Wife would probably say coffee's ready. Stays warm pretty long. I can always put it in the thermos. We have these thermos bottles. Okay, there's my pot of coffee. And I'm back to fully charged. It shows here only because the solar panel's on, putting an amp in. So it's showing that it's charging. Everything else is empty. Why is that light red? I don't know. Alright, so that's off. Let's unplug that. So the GFI tripped, but it was still brewing. That's odd. So I had the GFI tripped. You see? Oh, it does work. GFI does work. Okay, that's something new to me. Didn't do that before. I don't know why that was red. It's not red anymore. But the coffee pot's on. GFI works, so. All right, disregard that. Okay, so let's turn this off. Just unplug it. Let's go check our voltages. Okay, no load on, coffee pot's off. This showing 12.9 volts. I don't know how accurate that is. This is showing 12.6 volts. Putting an amp in on the solar, which isn't nothing, 13 watts. Okay,
let's go make some pizza.
Okay, I'm putting in an amp. All right, so this is the toaster oven, and this is this is 1,000 watts. This is 900. There's my pot of coffee. It's 1,000 watts. Okay, so with that red light just flickered. I wonder what that means. I don't know. So let's plug this in. Alright. Let's plug this in. Let's take this out. Okay, pizza's in there. This is gonna be a 15-minute test. We're gonna put it on bake, and no, I think we put it on temperature, 375, 350, 450, about there. Okay, 15 minutes, that's on, again we're drawing 2/3, and let's go out and check the voltages, making pizza, a toaster oven, on inverter power. This is longer than the coffee. Alright, so that's at 1,000 watts, and we're only drawing 860, so it's significantly lower, but we are down to 11.8 volts with this draw, which is fine. 11.9. So these two match up, 11.9. 11.8 when there's a draw on it. So I would think that's accurate. Maybe this one's accurate, this one isn't. All right, that goes on and off. That's not constantly on like the coffee maker. So let's come back in 15 minutes and see what my voltage will end up being. Okay,
be back.
Okay, so pizza just got done. Look at that, a little burnt. I like it burnt. And my batteries are 2/3 now. This just clicked off. This is red again. Strangest thing, right? And just a push of a reset, that goes off, but it doesn't affect the plug. The plug's a little warm. All right, let's go check the voltages. So I made coffee and I made pizza. Let's see where we're at here. Just lock this door up. And 12.4 volts. No load, 12.7 volts.
I'll probably get my meter out and let's check the actual battery voltage. I have my meter right here. So
this is cooking two things. So 12.4, what do you think I'm at? 60% capacity? I think 12.2 is 50%. Okay. Okay. I am at 12.51 volts. On these two Duracell 75 amp hour batteries, 12.51. That corresponds with this one. It's a 0.1 volt off. And that one's a little higher. Solar is snoozing now. So I would say this one's more accurate. I don't know why the Krieger is off. They
It might do that so it doesn't go off. They keep it at a higher voltage, so at 10.5 it may prolong it. You'll be able to use it longer. It's probably just a margin. All right, so 12.4. And 12.5 here. All right, so that is my final voltage. And like I says, I would probably have the truck battery plugged in, which I might do. Let me turn the truck around and plug it in and let's see what we get while I have this test going. Okay, so it's been a few minutes, 12.54. That's because the solar's probably putting small amps in. I'm at 12.5 here, so it kind of evened itself out from my meter to here. Half an amp, that's 12.8, so I could confirm that that's not accurate, that the solar charger is 12.54. and I guess to end this video, I will plug the truck in. Now remember, I'm running off one battery in the truck, the camper package battery. So it doesn't really bring me up in voltage. I guess it will equalize to whatever that is, but these batteries will win over the truck. Oops. Okay. So, that's it. That's my video. 12.5. So what I do, since I don't want to run a generator, the pizza was done, my son's eating that, my coffee's done, we're showing full here. Let me just do a test here, and I'll show you what I do also. If I turn this on, of course we're gonna draw voltage. So this oven is on, and what I have is my auto starter in the truck. I could just start while I'm in bed if my wife wants to make coffee and if the battery's over low. So what I do is if I don't have good batteries in the morning, I will start the truck by inside. From the oven. I don't know if this is showing you guys anything. So the voltage stays down while it's drawing, but I'm sure the truck's putting amps in. I just gave my amp meter away. It's 1.7. Let's go turn the oven off. And I'm sure the alternator's helping with the cause that I'm not down below 11 point whatever. Let's just turn this off. Let's turn this off. There's that light again. I don't know about that light. Yeah.
see, this is quieter than a generator. If I had to, I'd get the generator out and just plug it in and we'd run that. Conclude this video. I hope I spoke loud enough. I know I talk quiet, but that's it. Any questions, let me know. Peace out.